Because you fucked off because you get plugged?
Yeah, so I was, at that point, I'd switched over.
Were you a loose cannon at that age, 19?
I just fucking loved fighting.
I just, but outside the ring?
Yeah, I wasn't into like guns and knives. That mm-hmm. that just wasn't my thing. Like all my mates fucking at that time like went into it and that and were just mad. But I was just mad where I just wanted to fucking fight with anyone and everyone. If there was a problem, I'd be like, yeah, I'm there. And my coach, you know, he loved the way I was in the gym. I trained really hard and I dedicated myself, but then he'd see me going off and like causing trouble and getting into troubles, and you know, I was finding ways to earn money, and I was always having bother with like maybe a few lads, a few gangs and whatever, and I was in a party, wasn't I, and I wasn't having trouble with this gang of lads. I was just in a party and one of my mates was just fighting with this gang of lads. And, you know, obviously, just fucking being psychotic, I just went over to just try and sort it. So I just started having, like, murder with this group of lads. But at that point, the club was just going insane. I felt like everyone was having murder when I think back to it. And some lad come behind me and stabbed me, and I didn't feel it. I had a white T-shirt on, because when I looked at it after on the cameras, you see what happens. So I'm just like hitting everyone and everyone in my way, and this lad comes up and he stabs me once, and then he walks away, but I haven't moved or anything. I'm just fighting, I haven't felt it, and then he comes back around and he's like, fucking hell, this fucking kid's still fighting, and he does it again. And then, mate, for like I'd say 10 minutes after that, I was fighting with the doorman. Do you know what, just to like put it in a nutshell, I fucking battered everyone in view. Like, I couldn't be stopped. People were smashing bottles on me and everything. The doorman were fucking even cracking me, and I wouldn't go down. I was just went psychotic. And then I got backed up by the doorman and loads of people. My mates were just going mad. Like, I don't even know where they were. I got backed into a corner in the toilets, and they were like, Darren, you need to, like, I knew the doorman. They were like, you need to stop. You've been stabbed. And I was like, I haven't. I was going mental. And then I looked down and my top was just red. It just changed the colour red. And I was like, whoa. I was like, nah, fuck that. And I started, I was on the like the toilet seat thing, and I was kicking the door and that. And then as I've come out the toilet, I'm still fighting. And next minute, I've just got like a surge of like I come down and I just went, whoa. And like collapsed on the stairs. And I was like, this is what I remember back to. I was like, whoa, I can't even move. And then the doorman, they dragged me up to the front doors of the club in town. And the head doorman, he pulled me against the wall. And this is the God's honest truth, I remember this bright as day. So I'm sat there and he's going, you've been stabbed, Dad. I need to put my fingers in your wound. So he, I think he had like army. So he put his fingers in my wound, and he's going, I need you to stay awake. And I was going, nah. And I kept trying to like shut my eyes. He was going, Darren, I can't let you shut your eyes. You're not dying. He was saying all that stuff to me. So he had his fingers in my wound, and like I'm just like that, whoa, what's going on? And I remember like seeing all people around, like crying and that. And then I seen like blue flashing lights, the ambulance, and he still got us. And I wanted to go to sleep at this point. I was just like, well, nah, just let me sleep. And I believe to this day, if I would have like went to sleep, I would have died. Because the where I'd been stabbed was so close to my arteries. Like even the doctor who did the surgery on me, he was like, Darren, one more little bit and it had ruptured both your arteries, you wouldn't have survived. So like, I think of stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And I remember being in the ambulance, and I was going to the woman, just tell me if I'm going to die. And she wouldn't answer me. And I was going, just tell me if I'm... And she kept turning her head, and I was going, they had me strapped with my arms, and I started like shaking the thing, and I was going, just fucking tell me if I'm going to die. And she was like, no, you're not going to die. And I remember getting carted off to the hospital, and I woke up like 2 days later, so, and my mum and some friends and that were like standing at the end of my bed.
How was that feeling?
Do you know what, mate? I'd be probably lying to you if I said that it meant to me. I was just like, fucking hell, I got stabbed. Wow. I was like, I'm gonna have to kill that lad in the scene. I was like, but a lot of people cared for me, especially in the gym. A lot of people come to see me, and you know, I'm not gonna name no names, but they all come to see me and just give me words of wisdom. And you know, when I got out, I didn't go home. At that time, I can't even remember where I was living, mate. I'd been kicked out my mother's, I'd lived with my uncle, been kicked out. I'd lived with me fucking, my granddad, been kicked out, gone back. So I think I was living in my granddad's. I didn't go my granddad's, I didn't go my mother's. I went straight to the gym to see Colin. And I remember it was a Tuesday morning. All the fighters were in there, Terry, Mark. And I remember seeing Colin. Colin just looked at me, and I was on crutches, and I just sat on the ring. And like, Mark and a few of the lads come over to me and Terry and that, and then I waited till the end until to see Colin. And Colin was like, listen, I want to chat to you later on. Like, we'll have a chat and that. I said, all right, do you want me to come back, Col? He said, yeah. So I went to my granddad's, fucking just ate some food, and then I went back to the classes in the night. And Colin was sitting on the radiators, and he said, come over here, son. So I went out, hobbled over on my crutch, and he went, listen, what do you want from life? He's like, what? He's very straight and dry, Colin. Like, as I say, he's the most influential man in my life right now, and has been for years. But he's went, what do you want? He's like, I'm not just going to blow smoke up your ass. He's like, you've got the potential, Darren, to be the best in the world. I've seen it. I can make it happen, blah, blah, blah. But he's like, you're 50-50 now. He's like, you're training, but you're going out and you're just being a fucking moron, basically. He's like, what do you want? And I was like, you know, Carl, fucking, I don't really know. I just want to be the best. He's like, well, if you want to be the best, I'm gonna send you to Brazil. I'm gonna send you over there. You're gonna stay there for as long as you need to stay, and get yourself dedicated. Don't think about anything else. Don't think about having money or anything. Just fucking go and smash it. I was like, all right then. So, like a lot, I know 90% of people are like, nah, I'm not going to Brazil. Comfort zone, stuff like that. And I was just at that time, even though I had family and that, I didn't really have anything. I didn't have like. Nothing was important to me.
Are you homeless?
Sorry?
Are you homeless?
No, I wasn't. No, that's what I say.
I was floating from house to house.
Basically, I had the, like, when I say about, this is backtracking a bit now, but to be like open and honest, I had a great relationship with my mother and father growing up, and me and my mum were always very close. And then when I was like 15, 16, an incident occurred with my mother. I went out, it was New Year's Eve, went out with my friend Christopher. Come back about 12 o'clock. We've been out, you know, just causing murder.
As you do.
I said, come on, you can stay in the van, you know. I lived in my mum's box room, just fucking small room. He's like, yeah, all right, son. So then we've gone to sleep, and my mum's quite a hothead. I probably get me.
Is that where you get it from?
Probably get me angry. Yeah. I'm two things. I'm very angry when I need to be, and I'm stubborn. And my mum's two of them things. Like, I just woke up to screaming, and my mum's like, at that point, me and my mum were going down a spiral because she seen what was happening with me. You know, she knew at that point she like accepted fucking Darren's really good fighter. Like, she'd been to see me fight every blah, blah, blah. But she was like, he's fucking mental. Like, he's loose. Like, he's fucking, I was just fucking loose, mate. Well, as I say, I wasn't a fucking mad criminal. You know, I'd fucking done things and that, but I wasn't like involved with guns and knives. I just fucking wanted to fucking bash anyone. But there was none of this, like, in my head, respect for anyone. I always used to think, who's the hardest bastard in the pool? I'd fucking kill him. You know what I mean? I hope the fucking hardest bastard in the pool. Now I was like, what are you on about me? There's that many.